This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to create northern lights in a clear night Arctic sky filled with stars. I provided this photo of a starry night above the Arctic mountain range that you can download. Its link is in my video's description or project files. Before we begin, if you haven't already, click that subscribe button at the lower right to let you know as soon as I upload new Photoshop tutorials. First, we'll make a selection of the sky, which we'll use later to confine our northern lights behind the mountains. Open the Quick Selection tool and make its size anywhere from 5 to 10 pixels. Drag it just below the top edge along the mountains. To remove areas of the selection, press and hold Alt or Option as you drag over those areas. Invert the selection by pressing Ctrl or Command-Shift-I. Go to Select and Save Selection. When you see this window, just click OK. Deselect it by pressing Ctrl or Command-D. Click the New Layer icon to make a new layer. Click the foreground color to open the color picker. I'll pick a bright green since I think most of the impressive northern lights have this as their predominant color. However, feel free to pick any color you like. Open your pencil tool and pencil picker. Pick a hard round brush. We'll adjust its size in a minute. Its hardness and opacity are both 100%. Then press Enter or Return. Press the F5 key at the top of your keyboard to open your brush settings panel. You could also go to Window and Brush Settings. Click Brush Tip Shape. Make its size 40 pixels, the hardness 100%, and the spacing approximately 230%. Click Shape Dynamics. This adjusts the tip shape variations. Keep all of the controls off. The size jitter is 100%. The minimum diameter, angle jitter, and roundness jitter are all 0%. Click Scattering. This adjusts the distance and amount of brushes. The scatter is 400% and both axes is checked. The controls are off. The count is 10 and the count jitter is 20%. Click Transfer. This adjusts the dynamics for the buildup of the paint or effect. Make the opacity jitter 70%. Smoothing is irrelevant in this case since this affects the smoothness of paths. Brush horizontally across back and forth, including some random areas. We'll convert the brush strokes into a smart object so we can modify it non-destructively and copy its effects to the layers we'll be adding on top of it. To do this, click the icon at the upper right and click Convert to Smart Object. Go to Filter, Blur, and Motion Blur. The angle is 90 degrees. And the distance is 300 pixels. Go back to Filter, Blur, and this time Gaussian Blur. Blur it 5 pixels. Next, we'll even out the bottom. Click the Layer Mask icon to make a layer mask next to the brush strokes. Open your Brush Tool and Brush Picker. Pick a soft, round brush. Make its size 150 pixels, its hardness 0%, and its opacity and flow both 100%. Go to the left side of the document near the bottom of your strokes and press and hold the Shift key as you drag your cursor to the opposite side. Pressing Shift kept your stroke perfectly horizontal as you dragged it. I'll brush under it as well to ensure that all of my brush strokes are masked out. Click the New Layer icon to make a new layer. Open back your pencil tool and click the foreground color to open the color picker. Pick a lighter tint of the color you picked earlier. Drag your cursor along the bottom and brush in a few random strokes. Convert this layer into a smart object as well. We'll copy the smart filters onto the new brush strokes by going to this icon and pressing and holding Alt or Option as you drag it up next to the top layer. We'll mask out the bottom of these new strokes by going to the layer mask and dragging a copy of it next to the top strokes. Click off the chain link icon to unlink the layer and the layer mask. This allows us to resize and/or reposition either of them independently of the other. Make the new brush strokes layer active and press V to open your move tool. Make sure auto select is not checked. Drag the brush strokes down approximately this much. We'll compress the strokes vertically by opening the transform tool. Press Ctrl or Command T. If you see this message, it's just letting us know that the smart filters will be temporarily turned off while we use the transform tool. Go to the top middle anchor point and press and hold the Shift key as you drag it down approximately this much. Drag it up until we see more of the brush strokes, then press Enter or Return. Make a new layer. Click the foreground color and this time pick another color to add to your northern lights. Press B to open back your pencil tool and randomly brush over it. As before, convert it into a smart object and copy over the smart filters and layer mask. I think I'd like to make the yellow strokes a bit more transparent, so I'll make that layer active and reduce its opacity. We'll drag our lights down to make room for the motion blur that we're going to lengthen. First, link the layers and their layer masks, and then shift-click the bottom lights to make all of the lights active. Press V to open back the Move tool and drag the lights down. Open the top smart filters and double-click Motion Blur to open it. As before, click OK. Make the distance 800 pixels. Close the smart filters and shift-click the bottom lights layer to make all of them active. Drag them up and convert them into a smart object so we can warp their shapes together. Open your transform tool and click the warp transform icon. Open the warp list and click flag. To adjust the amount of warp, you can either type in the amount or drag the warp scrubby slider to the right or left. Type in minus 27. Drag it up to an area that looks good to you. Make a copy of it by pressing Ctrl or Command J. Open the Transform tool and click the Warp Transform icon. Open the Warp preset list and this time click Arch. For its bend, type in minus 50. Position it so the right edge is aligned under the right edge of the top lights. Don't be concerned that a couple of the lights are being cut off at the top. We'll be blurring it further, which will take care of it. Reduce its opacity to 70%. Go to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. Blur it 5 pixels. I'll drag it up a bit higher. Next, we'll gradually fade out the left of the bottom lights. Click the layer mask icon to make a layer mask next to the top layer, which is our bottom lights. Open your gradient tool and gradient picker. Click the black and white thumbnail and make sure the linear gradient icon is active. Place your tool to the left of the lights and press and hold the shift key as you drag the tool approximately to here and release. Convert these two layers into one smart object. Open your Channels panel. If you don't see it, go to Window and Channels. Ctrl-click or Command-click the Alpha 1 channel to make a selection of the sky that you made earlier. Open back the Layers panel and click the Layer Mask icon to make a layer mask of the selection next to the lights. Unlink the layer and the layer mask so we can angle our northern lights in perspective while keeping the layer mask in place. Make the lights layer active and open your transform tool. Let's zoom out of our image to give us more room on our canvas. Press Ctrl or Command and the minus key twice. Go to a bottom corner and press and hold Alt-Control-Shift on Windows or Option-Command-Shift on a Mac as you drag it out approximately this much. Drag it down approximately this far. Go to the top middle anchor point and press and hold Shift as you drag it up approximately this much. To adjust its overall size, go to a top corner. If you're using a version earlier than CC 2019, press and hold Alt or Option plus Shift as you drag it in. If you're using a later version, just press and hold Alt or Option as you drag it. Feel free to finesse its size, angle, and position to your liking. Then press Enter or Return. To zoom back in, press Ctrl or Command 0. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.